It brought us the Roaring Twenties, the Space Age and the Information Age, the 50s and the 60s. Radio, television, satellites and cell phones all caught up in a swirling sea of change. And it introduced a new voice in music, our voice. From the ground to the air to the sky to the concert hall, this has been the American Century. Welcome to The American Century, an exploration of America's modern musical legacy, hosted by David Dubal. The American Century is sponsored on 96.3 FM WQXR by American Century Investments, with over 40 years mutual fund management experience.
I'm David Dubal. Welcome to the American Century, WQXR's survey of America's enormous contribution to art music since the turn of the century. Today we have a varied program offering music of five American masters: Otto Luening, Ned Roram, George Antile, Carlisle Floyd, and Peter Menin. Otto Luening was born in Milwaukee in 1900. He lived until 1996, and it was a grand life he had, and he was a grand man, a person of deep thought and great good cheer. I was privileged to know Otto Luening during his later career. If you want to read a delightful book, quite long, but packed with our century, read Luening's Odyssey of an American Composer. No padding to the paragraph, just lots happening. He once told me when he was around age 75 that he started to lose some of his memory. This he simply could not tolerate. He decided to learn all of Bach's two-part inventions to help his memory. The project went so well, he never had any problems with memory again. Bach saved him. He said, "It may well be a miraculous prescription." Luening was a flutist, and he left some beautiful music for his instrument. Our first selection today, his lyrics scene for flute and orchestra, composed in 1951 in memory of Ferruccio Busoni, the great pianist conductor who he adored. Per Oyen is the flutist. José Cerebrier conducts the Oslo Philharmonic Orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
That was Otto Luening's Lyric Scene for Flute and Orchestra. José Cerebrier was heard at the helm of the Oslo Philharmonic with flute soloist Per Øyen. This is the American Century, heard on 96.3 FM WQXR. I'm David Dubal, and I'm pleased to be your guide on these programs of American music. For the next 14 minutes, we will listen to the second piano sonata of Ned Roram. In 1998, Roram celebrated his 75th birthday. Born in Richmond, Indiana, his life has been quite fabulous. Like Luening, he has documented himself in a scintillating autobiography and has written many controversial works, including his well-known diaries. Roram knew and knows the entire artistic world of the last half century. His songs are perhaps the best known of any American composer, although he writes in many forms. His piano sonata number 2 from 1949 is an ingratiating piece, French influenced in its mood and clarity. The composer calls it a garland of four happy songs. The first movement has a yearning quality. Then comes a bubbling tarantella, followed by a nocturne and concluding with a toccata. Roram's close friend, Julius Katchen, who died in his early 40s, played it joyously. Fortunately, Katchen put the sonata on record, and we'll hear him play Ned Roram's sonata number 2. Thank you. That was Ned Roram's second piano sonata with the late Julius Katchen performing. This is the American Century, and we'll continue with music by George Antile right after these words from our sponsor. George Antile, born in Trenton, New Jersey in 1900, the same year as Looning and Aaron Copland, for that matter, did not live the long life they did, living only until 1959. But his was a remarkable life, which, like Roram and Looning, he documented in his charming autobiography, The Bad Boy of Music. The book is filled with anecdotes such as playing piano recitals with a revolver on the piano in case anyone left during the performance. He lived in Hollywood for a time and hobnobbed with movie stars, as well as writing a syndicated column for The Lovelorn. The work that brought him fame in Paris was the ballet Mécanique, which created really a scandal. Today we hear his A Jazz Symphony from 1925, which reveals Antile's wonderful grasp of this style at the same time that many American and European composers were becoming jazz-influenced. Let's listen to A Jazz Symphony by George Antile, the Bad Boy of Music, performed by Michael Tilson Thomas, conducting the New World Symphony. The trumpet player is Mark Inouye, and Michael Linville is heard at the piano.
Thank you.
you have hopefully enjoyed to the full George Antheil's A Jazz Symphony. Michael Tilson Thomas conducted the New World Symphony. The trumpet was played by Mark J. Inouye, Michael Linville at the piano. Our next musical offering on today's edition of The American Century, music by American composers, is an aria from Carlisle Floyd's opera Susanna called The Trees and the Mountains. Carlisle Floyd was born in Latta, South Carolina in 1926, and at Syracuse University he studied with Ernest Bacon, a superb composer himself. Floyd's operas have long been successful, such as Slow Dusk, Wuthering Heights, Of Mice and Men, and most of all, Susanna, an opera of real repertory status. I think one of the great theater works by an American composer. In this performance of The Trees in the Mountains from Susanna, Renee Fleming is the soprano with the Metropolitan Opera Orchestra, conducted by James Levine.
Oh,
You have just heard an aria from Carlisle Floyd's best-known opera, Susanna, its title, The Trees and the Mountains. The soprano was Renee Fleming, and James Levine conducted his Metropolitan Opera Orchestra. Now for the concluding music on today's program, The American Century, we hear the Allegro Tempestuoso movement of Peter Menon's extraordinary Fifth Symphony. Menon was born in Erie, Pennsylvania in 1923 and died in New York in 1983. For 20 years until his death, he was president of the Juilliard School. Virgil Thomson wrote that Menon is a composer almost exclusively of serious symphonic and chamber music, distinguished by straightforward thematic material, a soaring melodic line, and strong structures. He wrote seven symphonies that rank, I think, with the symphonies of Sessions, Diamond, William Schumann, and Roy Harris as part of a proud symphonic American heritage. We hear the finale of the Fifth Symphony by Menon, a work which he says is of rapid and bare linear writing. The Rochester Orchestra is conducted by Howard Hansen.
Thank you.
That, I think, is action-packed music. It was our final work on today's edition of The American Century. It was the third movement of the late Peter Menin's Fifth Symphony, composed and completed in 1950. Howard Hanson conducted the Eastman Rochester Symphony. We'll return in a moment with a word about next week's program right after this message from American Century Investments. American Century, with over 40 years mutual fund management experience. On next week's program, we will hear music by Virgil Thompson, William Grant Still, David Guion, and Douglas Moore, each having contributed to the American Century. This is David Dubal. Thank you for listening.
Thank you.